I am very excited. This is my very first interview of the year, finally coming back for 2023. And I'm going to welcome Mary Coughlan, who is...
Coughlan. I'll help you there. Coughlan.
I was wondering how you would say that. So it's Coughlan. That's...
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's interesting because that sounds like a K to me, but it's, you C O U. Yeah. So yeah. Coughlan, Mary.
Coughlan. That's me.
That's you.
And you're Caroline. So nice to meet you, Caroline.
Nice to meet you, Mary. And truly, you're based right now in your hometown in Ireland. Where are you in Ireland?
I'm in County Wicklow, which is just about, it's about 20 kilometres outside of Dublin in the mountains. And it's very, very beautiful here. And it's very, very cold at the moment, but spring is on the way.
Beautiful, beautiful.
And I'm leaving.
Yeah, well, and why we're talking to you today, because, you're actually embarking to come out to Australia, and, you have been here before. What year were you here last?
Well, I think it was 2018 or, the years just seem to, I've lost all the COVID years. 2018, I was definitely there. I did quite a number of gigs, yeah.
You did.
And then, but I've been coming down almost every other year for the past 17 or 18 years.
Okay.
So it's brilliant. I love it.
Yeah. And we're very proud to be, Australians here. We feel like...
I've probably seen more of Australia than a lot of people, I think. I've been coast to coast and up to Cape Tribulation and right into the middle of Uluru and... all over. Yeah.
That's what, it's amazing, with your talent that can bring you there. And which is, you're actually going to be touring, your new album called Life Stories. And
yes.
Tell us about that, Mary, because this is a really interesting, album which really reflects a little bit of your back end of your life. And
I was going to release it in 2020. I've been working on it for about a year and a half, and with a guy called Pete Lannister. I kind of wanted to do something when I was 64, and I wanted it to be sort of not my final CD or anything, but I wanted it to be kind of big and loud, and I wanted it, as they say over here, to do the business, we finished it in January, February. I came home from London and people were beginning to talk about like this weird bug, but I didn't take any notice of it really. And we went ahead with plans. We did we got a release date and we got some publicity people on board, and then the next minute everything was cancelled. But I still wanted to release the album for my birthday when I was 64. So I went ahead and released the album, and then spent the entire rest every day for the next 18 months signing CDs from my kitchen table and doing very little else. But that was nice. I started to draw pictures for people. I started to paint little tiny pictures and put them in with the CDs. And it actually became a big thing. People were sending me back photographs of the framed pictures.
Oh, wow.
And then they were ordering them for other people. Then they wanted birthday cards, and then they wanted, special occasion cards.
Yeah.
So anyways, it was fun, and I got my grandchildren involved, and it was really good. So, and then it's really only now that we've caught up this past year, 2022, 2023, that we've caught up with the gigs,
Yeah.
So I had been booked to come to Australia. I had hoped to come in 2021 and to New Zealand. But here I am, 2023. So the album is actually almost 3 years old, but I still call it my new CD. So
it's funny. Look, the activity of now, the tours of coming back. We've just had this weekend Ed Sheeran and Sting in town. At the same time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, huge.
They're
Yeah. Harry Styles is
huge.
just about to embark to come here. He's headlining Perth first. So it's everybody's coming back on live, stages, which is.
It's been unmercifully busy here. It's like unbelievable. Every single band that ever toured has been to Ireland in the past 12 months. And I've probably done more gigs in the past 18 months than I've ever done in my life before. In a particular time period, if you know what I mean. Because it was just that everything got cancelled, and when they came back, they all came back together. And it was, can you do a gig? Can you do a gig? Can you do a gig? So I'm really looking forward to coming down, and I think they've probably sent you a copy of the album. And so I haven't really toured the album, you know what I mean? It's not like it normally was. I just put the album out there. It got a lot of radio play. It was number one in Ireland, got into British charts,
It's
which was a
beautiful.
thing in itself. And yeah, an achievement for in lockdown, you know.
Oh, it is a great
So
achievement, Mary. Your voice is absolutely stunning. It really, it crosses over, beautifully with, with the compositions of your songs, which are blues and jazz. But you're very sultry, and and it's emotion and moving, and you're a storyteller, in your
I like
music.
to tell stories, and I like to talk a lot of about the songs when I'm doing gigs. Yeah, I'm a bit of a storyteller. I did a gig last night, and they do go on a bit because I like to tell stories. And people tell me if I ever stop singing, I'll be able to do stand up because I'm quite funny sometimes, believe it or not. Because
Is
there's a
that the
lot of
Irish in
darkness.
you? Is that your Irish, nature, do you think? And
No, I mean, I'm not afraid to go to dark places, but then they're funny. Sometimes I just tell people what's in my head, which is fairly random, But I just love it. I'm more comfortable than I ever was before in my own skin, and doing concerts and with the audiences. I mean, when I was in the 80s, when I was like doing a lot of big, huge, enormous gigs in the 80s and the 90s, they were very impersonal. I was very shy. I didn't have a craft, I knew. I just closed my eyes and sang, and I was often very far away from the audience because it was bigger audiences. Now the audiences are smaller, they're much more manageable, and they're really intimate affairs. And when I stopped drinking 29 years ago, I decided that I'd go back on the road on my own terms. I didn't have an agent. I didn't have a manager. I got rid of everybody, and I surrounded myself with musicians who were pretty much sober, the same as I was, and went off on our own, four of us in a vehicle, and started to do gigs in small arts centres, like right back to where I started. All over England and Europe and Finland, Scandinavia, and all over Ireland. So I just felt it was more manageable, and I could make a living, and I could keep people in work, and I could have my home and my kids. And because before that, I was going to actually give up, because I never thought I'd be able to go back on the road and not drink and take drugs,
But
So I did it on my terms, and I'm still at it, which is great.
what tell me, what is the secret in terms of, converting from that to where you did? Because, yeah, that takes a lot of strength to do what you've done, to stop the drinking, and it's a completely different mindset, isn't it? And
Yeah, it was. Well, I almost died. I ended up on life support in hospital, so it was not a.
that's a big one.
I had tried to give up a few times on my own, and I would stay off the drink for, a month, 2 months, 3 months even, and then I just, something would happen, and that would be me gone for another 2 weeks, just at the end of a bottle. So yeah, I ended up in a pretty bad way, and I went to a place in Dublin called the Rutland Centre, which is a really hardcore rehab place, 29 years ago, nearly 30 years ago. So That and a lot of one-to-one counselling every week for almost about 8 years.
Wow.
And group therapy for 2 years. Yeah. And a lot of hard work. And a lot of, I had to win back all the, you know, the trust of my family and my friends and everybody in the business as well, you know.
Yeah.
Because I really, we messed up, you know.
Yeah. But that's amazing. You did it. You have achieved it. And, you know, and yeah, and look at you now. You must be so proud of yourself, and everyone else in your circles must be.
I guess I have to say that I am. I'm in a very happy place, and have been for quite a while now. I have a wonderful family. I have 6 grandchildren. Some of them live here with me. I'm living in the West Wing, I call it. I don't call it the granny flat. The kids are back in the house, and that was something I never thought I'd see, because, you know, it just didn't look like that was going to be, you know, a scenario for a long, long time.
Yeah.
So, so I'm happy. I'm working a lot. I did a one woman show, and then I did, I wrote a piece called Woman Undone, which was a story of abuse, addiction and recovery. I wrote it with an Icelandic composer, Valgeir Sigurðsson, and I performed it with 4 other women. It was all sung, it was mostly sung. And a young dancer called Erin O'Reilly from New York played Little Mary. When I was a child, she threw herself around the stage for about 2 hours every night.
Wow.
She's an incredible dancer. She amazingly had red hair and looked like me when I was about 16. So it was really weird.
Wow.
So I did that. We toured that a lot, and we had booked a lot of festivals also for 2020, which all went down the toilet. And when I come back from Australia on the 15th of May, I'm moving into the Abbey Theatre in Dublin to work on a new project. So that's our national theatre. So I'm going to work on a new project there with them.
Fantastic. That is excellent news, Mary.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, looking forward to it.
Yeah, that is excellent. Well, I tell you what, I can't wait to see you in Brisbane. But
lovely.
Yeah, this is going to be so exciting. And basically, you are here from March the 10th, and you start in Victoria, and then you're touring, oh my God, to just about every city. You're going to Canberra, you're going to the New South Wales. You've got some regionals.
Yeah, we've got a few festivals. And then I got to New Zealand in the middle of it, then back again.
Yeah.
And it's going to be fab.
Yeah, it's going to be absolutely fab. And I'm sure all your fans are just going to be delighted to see you back in our shores. And so we're really looking forward to it. And I really thank you for, you know, speaking with me today. And I look forward to meeting you in person, Mary.
So I'll see you in Brisbane.
I'll see you in Brisbane.
I think it's the 16th of April, yeah, or the 15th.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Brilliant.
Brilliant. And have a wonderful...
Thank you, Karen. I'm sorry for the technical hitches.
No problem. It's all good. I understand the tech, so we don't need to get off.
Yes, bro.
It is. It's just... Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Thanks, Mary.